100 years ago, women in the province of Manitoba won the right to vote. It was the first jurisdiction in the country to do so. An exhibit marking this historic event, curated by the Manitoba Museum, is on display at the Canadian Museum of History until March 2017.
This exhibition is a long and detailed and thorough snapshot of a 15 or 20 years stretch of time in which various women, essentially from the bourgeoisie and the well-to-do class from Manitoba and Western Canada in general, started to claim simply equality of rights. Manitoba was both the product and the reflection of a broader current occurring, I would say, mainly in the English-speaking Protestant universe.
In countries like the United States and the United Kingdom, as well as in Canada, demonstrations, literature and promotional items fueled women's campaign to obtain the right to vote. Humor was one of the favorite ways to convey the message. Cartoons appeared in newspapers, and sometimes politicians would utter condescending comments, like Sir Redmond Roblin, the Premier of Manitoba, who said during a heated exchange with a suffragette, "Nice women don't want the vote." Those words became the title of this exhibition.
Not only does it address very well one specific instance, a key moment, a stepping stone, but in fact it talks about the present time as well. Because the quest for equality, representation, having a voice, these are words that we hear every day.
For Xavier Gélina, there's no doubt that the victory of the women of Manitoba opened the door for other women from coast to coast to be granted the right to vote. 2 years after Manitoba, Ottawa allowed women to vote at federal elections. Mr. Gélina says there is no doubt that this event is one of the building blocks of Canadian democracy.
This is one important building block that gradually led to the various charters and Bill of Rights, which have been common currency in Canada since the Canadian Bill of Rights of 1960.
This exhibition reveals the magnitude of the social bias women had to overcome on their way to obtain the right to vote. It is meant to help our generation better understand an important moment in the evolution of our democracy. For CPAC, I'm Philippe Murat.